Good evening, respected judges, chairpersons, teachers, and my dear friends. I'm going to take you through my paper presentation, which is a preoperative ultrasonographic examination of the vessels and risk of AV fistula non-maturation. As all of us know, an AV fistula, to be functional, requires a process which is called as maturation. This maturation process includes vessel remodeling, that is lumen dilatation, wall thickening, and increase in the blood flow. Qualification of patients for fistulas requires them to be judged physically, as well as an imaging examination needs to be done. There are many authors who have recommended a minimum venous diameter of 2.5 millimeter and an arterial diameter of 2 millimeters required for fistula creation. However, there has not been any such cutoff or threshold, and therefore many such institutes go ahead with the fistula creation even with 1.5 millimeter diameter of the vessels, and hence substantial amount of AV fistulas fail to mature. The aim of our study was to compare the preoperative vessel size and its effect on vessel size with USG and its effect on AV fistula maturation. We had a total of 165 native AV fistulas which were constructed, and various factors were studied, like demographic factors, comorbid conditions, the type and duration of CKD, and various other factors mentioned. But for the purpose of this presentation, we have included 113 AV fistulas who were examined preoperatively with an ultrasound to study the arterial and venous diameters and blood flow. And at the end of 6 weeks, they were assessed for maturation. The maturation of the AV fistula was judged on the base of KDOQI guidelines following the rule of six. A detailed pre-operative ultrasonographic examination was done. The arteries were examined for the diameter, the blood flows, presence of any intimal arterial thickness, presence of any calcification. While the veins were studied for presence of any thrombosis, the venous diameters, compressibility, and blood flows. Statistical analysis was performed. Coming to the results, as we can see, in the arterial sizes, there were 24 fistulas who had an arterial size of less than 2 millimeter diameter, and all of them failed to mature. That is, there was 100% non-maturation. While those who had a diameter of more than 2 millimeters, 89 fistulas were constructed, 72 matured, and 17 did not mature. That is, there was only 19% non-maturation. Coming to the venous sizes, the ones with less than 2 millimeter venous diameter, there was 63% non-maturation. 2 to 2.5 millimeters, 74% fistulas matured, while only 26% did not mature. And in more than 2.5 millimeter diameter, 88% fistulas matured and 12% did not mature. All the values were statistically significant, but when intergroup analysis between 2 to 2.5 and 2.5 millimeter group was done, there was no significant difference. Coming to the flow rates, as we see preoperatively, 5 fistulas had poor arterial flow rate and all of them failed to mature. While in the normal arterial flow rate, there were 72 fistulas matured and 36 did not mature. This was statistically significant. In the venous flow rates, there were only 2 fistulas who had poor blood flow preoperatively, and both of them did not mature. But these values were not statistically significant. So, to conclude, an arterial diameter of less than 2 millimeters and a poor arterial flow preoperatively are poor predictors of AV fistula maturation. While in the venous diameter, less than 2 millimeters carries a poor outcome. Between 2 to 2.5 millimeter, it's acceptable. But if we use more than 2.5 millimeter, it gives the best results. Poor arterial flows also lead to non-maturation, whereas venous flows do not matter as much as AV fistula maturation is considered. The diameter of the cephalic vein and blood flow velocity in the radial artery are connected to AV fistula maturation. So to conclude, I would like to suggest that an ultrasonographic examination should be performed for all patients who are going to go for an AV fistula creation, and also it should be used in the postoperative period for monitoring of the AV fistulas. And with the help of this, we can reduce the risk of failure and also unnecessary disqualifications from AV fistula creation. Thank you.
Yes,
you are talking about era of K-Doki. And I'll just tell you our experience at Sir Gangaram Hospital, which was way back before K-Doki, where we used to construct AV shunts. And at that time, we did not measure about the venous size or the diameter. What we used to do is dilate the vein, put in an AV shunt, and after 4 or 6 weeks, when this shunt is matured, we used to convert it into AV fistula, and we had a success of more than 95%. And actually, approximately 10,000 fistulas have been made between Dr. Rana Bhalla and myself. So I think because nowadays AV shunt is extinct, and we have to resort to these things. But I am talking about pre-Doki era.
What was the reason for excluding about 50 patients from your analysis?
So we had taken initially 165 patients, but we did not have we had not performed a preoperative Doppler and ultrasound, and all of the patients, they had just underwent the fistula without the ultrasonogram. That's why they were excluded. And also some of the patients failed to follow up with us by the end of 6 weeks. Hence we could not include them in the study.
Okay. Out of curiosity, did you try the cutoff of 1.5, and like you suggested, seemed to suggest in your introduction, you try a cutoff of 1.5 and see whether that could also be part of the good bracket?
Yes, sir, but we've not studied in this study, maybe.
Okay. Yeah. Any more questions?
Ms. Chairman, sorry for the interruption. We'll have to move on because of time for this place.
Thank you.